Hello students, in this session let us learn how to draw the class diagram. So class diagram is basically like a map that shows you how different parts of the computer system or the software system that you are working is brought together. So it helps us to see what are the various parts of the system do we have. Okay, like the system in the sense the classes that we have, what is the system actually having, which are called as attributes, and what they get to, what they can do, that is called as actions, and how basically all these are connected to each other. Okay, so class is basically having a name, attribute, as well as method, and we connect one class to the another class with different types of relationships. So let's see how exactly a class is going to look like. So you can see here the class is basically a rectangular box which is divided into three rows like this. Okay, the topmost row is called as the class name, the second row is called as the attribute, and the third row is called as the operation, right? So example you can take is a car class. So what the class name will be car. What will be the attribute of the car? It will be a car can have a color, it can have a name, it can have age, it can have cost, it can have a brand. That will be the attribute. What could be the operations? What can we do using a car? We can drive, okay, and we can accelerate, we can apply brake. So these are the operations that we can perform on the class, right? So basically in your software that you are developing, anything or any object or any action that is having its own attribute and operation becomes a class. Like me take an example of ATM system, in which I have an operation which is called as withdrawal. Withdrawal can also become a class. How? Withdrawal is the name of the class. What can be the attributes of withdrawal? Withdrawal can be having its transaction ID. Okay, it can be having the amount, how much amount am I withdrawing. So that can be the attribute. So what can be the method or the operation of the withdrawal? It could be getting the cash. Okay, so that can be the operation. Withdrawal is nothing but you're taking the cash. So that can be the operation that I'm performing on withdrawal. So though withdrawal is one of the action that is performed in my system, it can become a class because it is having its own attribute and operation. So you have to identify classes in such a way that any object or any person or any action which is having its own name, attribute and operation can become a class. Okay, so let's take an example of attributes. For example, what will be the attributes of car, color, model, speed? What will be the attributes of student, name, age, grade? Okay, and these attributes are generally written in the second block of your class. Class is this rectangular box. On top, you will be writing the class name. On the second block, you will be writing the attributes. So what will be the methods? Methods are nothing but what are the operations that are done by this particular class. So example, a car can... what will be the method for a car? It can drive, it can stop. For a student, he can study, he can enroll a course. These are the methods. So the methods will be written in the third block of this particular class. Okay, now let's see what are the various relationships that we can apply between these classes. Generally you have n number of relationships, but the two main important relationships that we'll be using in class diagram is association and generalization. Association is already shown in use case diagram, okay, but here the extra thing is along with association you have to even mention the multiplicity, in the sense one to one, one to many, that relationship you have to show, that is called association. Okay, then you have generalization. So in class diagram, generalization is called as inheritance. Just like in your OOPS concept, how you have a concept called as inheritance. What is inheritance? One class getting the properties from another class, that is called as inheritance. The same thing is happening in this class diagram. You use inheritance when one particular class is using the properties of another particular class. Then you will be using generalization, which is also called as inheritance, and this is the symbol that we will be using. Okay, like example, dog inherits from the animal, right? So you can see some more examples also, like for example, animal is a class and dog is another class. Dog is inheriting the properties of the animal class. So we will use inheritance here, right? So along with this association and inheritance, you can use any other type of relationship in class diagram. It is not compulsory that we have to use only these two. You can use anything upon the ideas that you get while you are creating a project and drawing this class diagram, right? So let's see how to draw this particular class diagram. So basically, to draw this class diagram, the first thing you have to do is to identify your classes, right? So if I take an ATM system, ATM is one class, customer is class, bank account is class, withdrawal is class. Now, why did I identify these as classes? Because they are having their own name and every class is having its own attributes and every class is also having its own methods. That is the reason I have identified them as classes. Okay. So, if I take example of ATM class, the attributes you can take is location and ATM ID. If I take customer class, attributes are name and customer ID. If I take bank account, the attributes are account number and balance. Okay. Similarly, methods. ATM methods will be authenticating the user, dispensing the cash. Customer will be having insert card, enter PIN. Bank account will be having checking the balance, withdrawal of money. So these are classes with attributes and methods. Now let us see an example of how a class diagram is going to be looking like for ATM system. So this is how you have to draw your class diagram as you're seeing here. So the classes that I have identified are bank class, ATM, ATM transaction class, withdrawal class, PIN validation class, account class, debit card class, customer class. Okay, so bank is having attributes like branch code, address. It is having methods like manages the accounts, maintains the customer records. Okay, now ATM. ATM attributes are location of the ATM, ATM ID. What all can you do? What will be the operations? Authenticate the user, dispense the cash. ATM transaction is one more class. What are the attributes? Transaction ID, date, type. What is its method? Update. Withdrawal transaction is another class. Amount is the attribute of the withdrawal class. Withdrawal is the action that is being performed. Okay, so like this we have to identify different types of classes and for each class we have to give attributes and names. Now let us look into the relationships that we have. So you can see there is an association relationship given between the bank and the ATM system. Okay, so this is the association. When you give association, you have to even mention the multiplicity also. So one bank is maintaining one or more ATM centers. So it is one to many relationship. One bank is having one or more customer. So it is one to many relationship. Okay. One or more customer can have one or more accounts. So it is many to many relationship. One or more customer can have zero or one debit card. So this is many to one relationship. So like this, whenever we are using associations, we have to even mention the multiplicity. Now look at this particular relationship here. Withdrawal transaction, PIN validation. Both come under the class which is called as ATM transaction. But since they are having their own attributes and methods, I have placed them as separate classes. So since these classes are having almost the same properties of this class, I will be using inheritance here, which is called as generalization. And this is the symbol. So this is how you have to draw the class diagram for ATM. Now in StarUML, I will show you how to draw the class diagram. Now in your StarUML, to the right side under the model, right click, click on add diagram and search for class diagram. Okay, so you will get all the symbols in the toolbox to the left side related to your class. Click on the class, come, drag and drop. So your class is ready. Give a class name. So let me say as ATM. This is my class name. Okay, now I have to give attribute. To give attribute, take the pointer to the top box of your class, double click there. Then you will get these symbols here as you can see. Click on the first symbol which says add attribute. Click on that, add the attribute. So what will be the attributes for your ATM? It will be the ATM ID. Okay. Now say suppose you want to add one more attribute. Click on this plus symbol here. After ATM attribute, it will be its location or the address. Okay. So once you finish adding n number of attributes here, go to some blank space here and click. So your attributes are ready. Now I have to add the methods. Again, go to the top box, double click here. The second option you will get here, add operation. Click on the operation, give operations. So what is the operation? Cash dispenser is one operation. Okay, so this is the operation that is successfully given. Now say suppose I'm adding one more class here. Okay, say suppose it is bank, right? Now I want to add attribute, so I'll double click here. I will add the attribute. So it will be having IFSC code. So every bank will be having one IFSC code and say some branch name here. Okay, so these are the two attributes that I have identified. Again, I will go on the top, double click. Now I will add operations. Okay, say maintains the accounts and manages the customers. These are the two operations. Now I have to give association between them. So I have a symbol called as association here. Click on the association, place the pointer on this particular ATM class, hold, drag and drop up till bank and leave. Your association is created. So bank maintains ATMs. Okay, so you have to write maintain. It's not mandatory to give any name. It's optional. You can even give. Now I have to give multiplicity here. To give multiplicity, go to one of the corner of this association line. Okay, double click here. You will get one drop down box here. From this drop down box, select one option. Okay, and click somewhere. So you got one here. Again, go back to one of the corner, double click here, drop down and give one or many. Okay, so I have one bank can maintain one or more ATMs. This is how you have to give the multiplicity and this is how you have to draw your class diagram. I hope you understood. Thank you.